Good morning and welcome to worship at Epworth United Methodist Church in Berkeley, California. It's Pride Sunday and we are so excited to be able to worship with you and also reconciling United Methodists from all over the globe. In our worship today, we'll have leadership from the Reconciling Ministries Network, and we hope that you will stay after the worship service today for a virtual Pride Parade organized by the Reconciling Ministries Network. If you look carefully, you'll see the famous rainbow doors from the Hopkins side of Epworth as part of this wonderful virtual parade. If you're new to Epworth, I want to say a special word of welcome to you and invite you to fill out one of the Connect cards, which you can find through a link in the chat. This will allow us to get you looped into everything that's happening in this vibrant community of faith and reach out to welcome you personally. And now let us make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Let us worship.
Greetings, friends. We are so glad you are joining with us in this Pride worship service. My name is Helen Ride and my pronouns are they, them, theirs. Wherever you are joining us from today, you are welcome. We're also grateful for the multitude of people across our connection who have contributed to this service. Thank you so very much. We'd love for you to leave comments and interact with others who might be watching with you online. We may be physically separated from each other, but we're so grateful for the many ways we can stay connected virtually. We're gathered here today to celebrate Pride, to celebrate the beauty and belovedness of all of God's creation. That's what Pride is about. It's celebrating what we know of ourselves, our LGBTQI community, our allies and our friends. We're giving thanks that God did not create a monochrome binary world. God created with expansiveness and generosity beyond our wildest dreams, rooted and grounded in our knowledge of each other as beloved. Imagine that. What a glorious picture of the kingdom of God. The flag behind me is a genderqueer pride flag that my friend Joey gave me several years ago when I was just beginning to be able to celebrate the fact that God created me agender from the beginning. I needed a new set of lenses to see myself as God had always seen me. I didn't always see my queerness as something God celebrated, as something that had always been good about me. But thankfully, I was stubborn enough to continue to pursue God, and God was and is persistent enough to continue pursuing me. Eventually, I found the new lenses God was offering me, a new way to see the way God sees. I was born again. Saved into a new way of seeing. For many of you, we recognize that this may be your first opportunity to participate in an LGBTQ affirming Pride worship service, which means that this might feel a little new and maybe you're feeling a little uncertain. I'd love to invite you into an idea. I'm sure it's not normal to start a worship service with an altar call, but I'd love to encourage you, if you're watching from a place where you know that maybe you're not perceiving as God does, maybe you're not loving yourself or others as you know God would like you to, you know you need a new set of lenses. Well, here's the good news. God has some ready just for you. Come and get them right now and be born again into a new way of celebrating, loving all of God's creation. You are welcome here. Let us worship together now.
We are the body of Christ. Baptized in one spirit, we are the members of one body. Many and varied in gender, color, sexuality, age, class, and ability, we are members of Christ's beautiful body. None of us can say to another, I have no need of you, for only together can we find wholeness. None of us can say to another, I will not care for you, for we are connected like muscle and bone. If one suffers, we all suffer. If one rejoices, we all rejoice. Thanks be to God who calls us to be one. Let us worship God.
Let us pray. Constant friend, because people of every sexual orientation, gender expression, and gender identity have the right to live with dignity and without persecution or discrimination, we remember in our prayers LGBTQ people of Chechnya, Uganda, Zambia, Saudi Arabia, Iraq, and elsewhere who have been murdered and tortured because of who they are. We remember them and the people who love them. LGBTQ refugees from around the world seeking safety and sanctuary. We remember them and the people who welcome them. Trans and gender diverse people in Canada, the United States, Brazil, and elsewhere who are targeted victims of hate crimes and assaults. We remember them and the people who love them. LGBTQ people whose dignity and self-esteem have been eroded by hateful systems and structures. We remember them and seek to be people who love more fully. Individually, we each uniquely reflect your glory and express your love. But anti-gay violence, homophobia, and transphobia have blocked many from recognizing your beauty in all people. All of creation suffers from the effects of such hate, fear, and violence. Daily, may we dedicate ourselves to building bridges of love and hope where harmful divisions have been made, making equity and equality for all people our goal, while working continually for justice so that everyone can live fully in your love. Amen.
So I want to start off by recognizing that I can only speak from my own experience, from my own perspective, as someone living in the United States, as a second-generation Filipino-American, as a child of immigrants, as someone who takes yearly pastoral and solidarity visits to the Philippines. And I have been doing so since 2008 with the California-Nevada-Philippines Solidarity Task Force. And it's in that context that I've been able to witness queer trans resilience outside of the United States. For myself, my queer and trans, non-binary trans identities have me reflecting on resilience and what it means to be resilient, you know, mostly because I have to practice resilience, you know, in this society. Not only that, but my identity as Filipino also has me reflecting on resilience as well, especially in the midst of this pandemic. In California, 20% of the nurses on the front lines are Filipino. Filipinos have been praised and admired for our resilience in the face of poverty, in the face of climate-related disasters, in the face of all the difficulties that leaving our families back home to work abroad entails, for our ability to bounce back, to still be able to laugh and to find joy, to bloom wherever we're planted. But resilience shouldn't and isn't meant to keep us from staying awake to and acknowledging the oppressive systems and the ways of dominant culture that force us to have to be resilient in the first place. Queer and trans people around the world continue to rise up and continue to serve others. Through partnership with National Council of Churches in the Philippines, I have seen queer and trans leadership in the church and as the church, providing relief to the poorest and the hungry, putting on forums to educate folks on public health issues and addressing violence against women, putting on theological forums that promote justice and explicitly condemn injustice, traveling around the world as advocates for human rights. I've met trans women leading labor unions for better wages, safer working conditions, and to put an end to contractualized labor. I've met queer and trans people who took part in occupying abandoned government housing in Bulacan in 2017. On social media last summer, I saw images of Pride in Manila, and I was so heartened to see that there were so many allies that showed up, and not showed up to take up space or to only party with us, but to rise up alongside the LGBTQ+ community in the call against discrimination, in the call for LGBTQ+ folks to have jobs, access to proper health care, and to have all our basic needs met that we may thrive and not merely survive. The folks that I've met there, they recognize that being queer and trans is another layer of oppression and is not the only struggle for our collective healing and wholeness. We assure the lives of those lost are not in vain when we join our resilient selves in solidarity with others, when we show up for each other, when we are present with one another, however we are able to do so. Many of us queer trans folks have no choice but to rise in solidarity because of who we are, because of the multiple aspects of our identities that make up who we are, because of our relationships, because of the people that we love. What I've seen and learned from our queer trans siblings' resilience worldwide is that we shine. Our queer trans resilience shines when we join with movements of our collective liberation, beyond labels of our identities and transcending our man-made borders.
Will you join me in a celebration litany adapted from the work of Diane New? Gracious and loving God of many names, we praise you for creating queer and trans people and those who love us. We honor those who work for change as people of faith inside and outside of religious structures. Let us thank those among us who have struggled and have achieved greater justice, and those who continue to struggle. Let us give thanks for those agitators and prophets among us who don't take party lines and who speak truth to power even when it is dangerous or when no one seems to be listening. Let us give thanks for those advocates among us who bring a moral voice to the world and speak boldly and courageously for themselves and for all of us. Let us give thanks for the peacemakers and reconcilers among us who draw us together and help share the beauty of all people. For the chance at a world where all people are celebrated and loved, thank you, God. For a global and timeless queer trans community that surpasses the limits of Western language, for God's beloved kin who are Katoi and Hijra in Thailand, Bangladesh, Pakistan, and India, Two Spirit on Turtle Island, Manya in Malaysia, Fafahin in Samoa, Mahu in Hawaii and Tahiti, and Fakaliti in Tonga, Babaylan and Bakla in the Philippines, Adafuru in Nigeria and Kuchu in East Africa, and all our human family around the world in all their sexual and gender diversity, diversity that more accurately reflects your image. Thank you, God. For queer and trans youth whose holy imaginations and fearlessness keep us in a constant state of redefinition. Thank you, God. For helping us break through the heterosexism, racism, sexism, homo-hatred, and transphobia in ourselves, in our families and friends, in our communities and cultures. Thank you, God. For the dignity and worth of each person. Thank you, God. For inspiring us with dreams and holy impatience, thank you, God. For challenging us to believe out loud, thank you, God. Loving God of many names, thank you for creating queer and trans people and our friends. Holy Creator, breathe new energies of kindness and love in the world. Wondrous wisdom, renew our commitment to work for justice for all. Amen.
Grace and peace be unto you from Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior in the faith. At this point in the service, we invite you to a time of reflection and of deep personal sharing. As you are comfortable and as you feel led, we would love to hear from you, all of those of us participating in the service. I ask that you open your hearts to remember who we call the saints of our lives. You may share your reflections with those around you, wherever you are, or you may say names aloud or speak names in silence in your own heart. And if you like, you may place names in the comments sections along with some brief description so that others of us online participating in the service might hear from you. So I'm going to invite you to remember with me the names of those with whom and for whom we exist today, as we are, fully are, because of the ways they lived and shared their witness and their lives with us. I'm going to share three beloved persons in my life who have made a huge difference to me in friendship, and in their spiritual witness. The first is Jean Audrey Powers, mentor, ecumenist, feminist, and lifelong friend. The second person is John Griffin Jr., a childhood friend of mine, lived across the street from me, graduated from high school together, best of friends. He came out to me while we were both in college, and later, sadly, he died from AIDS. I officiated his service. The last name is Karen Olivetto, proud, strong, loving sister bishop, a shero of mind, a friend, and a warrior for justice. Let us pause now as you offer your names in your hearts by the comment section to those around you. Be assured that we are all God's beloved children. Today and through the whole month of Pride, we will continue to recall the voices, the signs, the hugs, the prayers, the witness, and the intimate and vulnerable love of those whom we have named, those with whom we live, those with whom we have beautiful friendship and relationships, those with whom we have made sacred space. O God, we give thanks for the many reminders along the way that indeed we are not alone, you are with us. Thanks be to God.
Hi, brothers and sisters. I'm Pastor Rafael. My pronouns are he, him, his.
Hello. I'm Pastor Marvel from Brazil. My pronouns are he, him, his. It's a pleasure to be here along with you. To live in a country considered to be one of the most dangerous places for LGBTQ people in the world is not easy. But today, we are here to celebrate the grace and the power of love. Because we have been working here in Brazil for 11 years with full inclusion and reconciliation, and we understand that full inclusion needs visage, courage, bravery, spirituality, and presence. Amid so many persecutions and controversies against us, we need to resist, we need to be strong, we need to be together in person or virtually. In this moment of pandemic, we are working on Bible studies about what we can learn through this pandemic. And we are talking about subjects such as how fragile is our life in this world. And church are not buildings. And finally, we talked about how we can act as a reconciling church to provide assistance one another, especially to homeless people. During this quarantine, we are offering online worship services, pastoral care. We are using the tools on internet to help people to keep in touch with people. The temples are closed, but the church is alive more than ever. We have been doing effort to help people in need, especially with food, medicine, and personal hygiene products. In a time of persecution, in a time when we cannot trust our government, the best way to resist is by listening to the voice of love and not that of persecution. What does God say about you? That what matters.
I keep fighting voices in my mind that say I'm not enough. every single lie that tells me I will never measure up. Am I more than just the sum of every high and every low? Again, just who I am, 'cause I need to know. Ooh, you say I am loved when I can feel the thing. You say I am strong when I think I'm weak. You say I am held when I am falling short. And when
appreciate you, God's children. May God bless you all.
Thank you for this opportunity. Bye-bye.
I'm Scott Mitchell. I'm in lay leadership at Centenary United Methodist Church in Macon, Georgia, and I'm going to be reading a scripture from 1 Corinthians 13, 1-8. If I speak in tongues of human beings and of angels, but I don't have love, I'm a clanging gong or a clashing cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and I know all the mysteries and everything else, and I have such complete faith that I can move mountains, but I don't have love, I'm nothing. If I give away everything that I have and hand over my own body to feel good about what I've done, but I don't have love, I receive no benefit whatsoever. Love is patient. Love is kind. It isn't jealous. It doesn't brag. It isn't arrogant. It isn't rude. It doesn't seek its own advantage. It isn't irritable. It doesn't keep a record of complaints. It isn't happy with injustice. But it is happy with the truth. Love puts up with all things, trusts in all things, hopes for all things, endures all things. Love never fails.
I am loved. I am loved.
So don't be afraid to let them show your true colors. Your true colors are beautiful.
Greetings. I am Reverend Dr. Valerie L. Jackson, and I am a triple threat. I am a woman who is Black and queer, and with such ontological and existential realities, I am honored to share with you today, Still I Rise by Maya Angelou. You may write me down in history with your bitter, twisted lies. You may trod me in the very dirt, but still, like dust, I'll rise. Does my sassiness upset you? Why are you beset with gloom? 'Cause I walk like I've got oil wells pumping in my living room. Just like moons and like suns, with the certainty of tides, just like hopes springing high, still, I'll rise. Do you want to see me broken? Bowed head and lowered eyes, shoulders falling down like teardrops, weakened by my soulful cries? Does my haughtiness offend you? Don't you take it awful hard, 'cause I laugh like I've got gold mines digging in my own backyard. You may shoot me with your words. You may cut me with your eyes. You may kill me with your hatefulness, but still, like air, I'll rise. Does my sexiness upset you? Does it come as a surprise that I dance like I've got diamonds at the meetings of my thighs? Out of the huts of history's shame, I rise. Up from a past that's rooted in pain, I rise. I'm a Black ocean, leaping and wide. Welling and swelling, I bear in the tide. Leaving behind nights of terror and fear, I rise. Into a daybreak that's wondrously clear, I rise, bringing the gifts that my ancestors gave. I am the dream, I am the dream, I am the dream and the hope of the slave. I rise, thank God Almighty, I rise.
I bring you warm greetings from the Philippines, which is also very warm. I am reading from Paul's letter to the Galatians, the third chapter, verses 23 to 28. I'll be reading from two versions. One is a new translation from the Philippines, called the Pinoy version. It is a translation using the language of millennials, mixing Tagalog with English. And that's the way millennials now speak. Then after that, I will read from the Common English Bible, which is ours because it's published by the Methodist Publishing House. Listen now to Paul's letter to the Galatians. Dati, nakakulong tayo na parang bilanggo ng Jewish law. Hanggang sa dumating yung time na ipakita sa atin ng Diyos na katanggap-tanggap niya tayo pag nagtiwala tayo kay Jesus Christ. Ang Jewish law muna ang nagdisiplina sa atin hanggang sa dumating si Christ para tanggapin tayo ng Diyos dahil sa pagtitiwala natin kay Christ. At ngayong natutunan na nating magtiwala kay Christ, hindi na tayo under ng pagdidisiplina ng Jewish law. Kayong lahat ay mga anak na ng Diyos dahil sa pagtitiwala ninyo kay Christ Jesus. Nakipag-isa kayo kay Christ nung nababtize kayo. At ngayon, suot nyo na parang damit ang buhay ni Christ. So, wala nang pagkakaiba ang Jews at Gentiles, ang alipin at malaya, ang lalaki sa babae. Kasi, iisa na kayong lahat kay Kristo Jesus. And now, reading from the Common English Bible. Before faith came, we were guarded under the law, locked up until faith that was coming would be revealed, so that the law became our custodian until Christ, so that we might be made righteous by faith. But now that faith has come, we are no longer under a custodian. You are all God's children through faith in Christ Jesus. All of you who were baptized into Christ have clothed yourselves with Christ. There is neither Jew nor Greek, there is neither slave nor free, nor is there male and female, for you are all one in Christ Jesus. This is the word of God for the people of God. Amen.
Hello everyone, my name is Dennis Akona and I work for the Reconciling Ministry Network. Today I'm here to talk about resilience, and to me resilience is a situation where you are able to either overcome or withstand difficult challenges. And I would say, as an African proud gay man who is also a Christian, this is the life we live every day. You know, every day of our life we live on resilience. So resilient, as you know, is what has been keeping us going. So I will share a very unique situation about my journey as a refugee to the United States. So I'm originally from Nigeria, and back then in Nigeria I used to work as a healthcare worker, as a social worker that was providing HIV treatment and care for the LGBT community in Nigeria. And a client of ours was arrested and beaten and tortured, and he was told to give up names of other gay people he knows in the community. And my name was the first name he mentioned, and he told the officers that, you know, once they get me, they can get a list of other people that I work in a place that provide care for gay men. And, you know, he was beaten and tortured by the police officers, who are the same people that are supposed to protect us, you know, in Nigeria. Today, Nigeria have a law against same-sex relationship that was signed into law in 2014. And, you know, even before that, we had the penal code model that was also used as a form of punishment against the LGBTQ community. So I was arrested in 2012 for providing services for other LGBTQ community members, and after several days of being detained, beaten and tortured, I was eventually granted bail to also appear in the police station on a regular basis. But I realized that this was just a form for the government or for the police to extort me for my money. And because I was arrested in my community, I was getting a lot of threats from other community members. I was getting a lot of threats from even some of my family members. And I had to, you know, run for my safety. And I found myself in Chicago. So when I was coming to Chicago, I assumed Chicago was the best place in the world. I assumed the United States is the best country in the world, with peace and everything based on what we've seen in movies. But, you know, I realized that the United States has its own issues. You know, for me, it has been so difficult living as a black gay man who is Africa, who is African and who is a Nigerian in the south side of Chicago, who is also a refugee. And these are all different intersections that has been so difficult for me. And at every stage of my life, I have to overcome, you know, every challenges that I face. Either people see me as a refugee, or people attacking me as a gay man, or people attacking me as an African, or people even attacking me as a Nigerian. So for me, I go through these changes of challenges every day of my life. And what has been keeping me going is resilient. And I believe that that is what we have as a factor for the rest of our life. Today, I'm an American citizen, and I felt that becoming an American, there will be great change. Probably people will see me more better, or people will treat me differently. But everything still remains the same. You know, the church here does not provide support for us. Even the Methodist church we call our home does not provide us refuge. Even as an African gay man who is a refugee in the United States, I didn't get that refuge I thought I was going to get when I got here. But the fact that I had a very strong level of resilience in me, I've been able to survive every stages of my life to today. Thank God for the wonderful colleagues and friends I have that have always been there to support me, to give me peace. You know, for me, being around my colleagues or my friends is what really gives me joy. And also other people who has played like very important role in my life living here in the United States. Thank you so much, and God bless you all.
Heart by heart now, maybe now. but we can build a city for all. When your trust is all but shattered, when your faith is all but killed, you can give up, bitter and battered, or you can slowly start to build a beautiful city. Yes, we can. Yes, we can. We can build a beautiful city, not a city of
all. Let us pray. Spirit of life, source of beauty, great mystery. On this beautiful day, we give you thanks. We give thanks for this precious time. Help us meet this era with reverence, with joy, with intention. Help us to use it to its fullest, to meet whatever life has brought our way. If life has brought grief, help us grieve well. Help us acknowledge the depth of our sorrow and not hide from its tenderness. We embrace our grief, knowing we grieve when we have loved, knowing we grieve when we have allowed ourselves to hope, knowing we grieve when something precious has been lost to us. So if life has brought us grief, help us to grieve with bare honesty so we can move through our sorrow to healing. And if life has brought joy, help us celebrate well. Help us to stop and notice the blessings we have been giving. Help us acknowledge all those who have helped make our blessings possible. And let gratitude flourish in our spirits, growing us into generous ones in return. And help us celebrate honestly and graciously, knowing that joy is a gift. And if life has brought us confusion, help us sort through the tangled threads that seem unfathomable knots. Help us make peace with mystery while seeking wisdom. Here we are letting go of fear and nurturing the seeds that lie in every confusing time. Help us remember that seeking can in itself be an answer. And if life has brought us boredom, break us out of the illusion of smallness. Expand our minds and spirits until we can imagine 1,000 ways to be kind, 1,000 ways we can do to make life better for ourselves and for someone else,
Make us brave and daring with our time. And if life has brought us too much to do, too much to hold, too much to manage, too much, help us find a spirit of calm amidst it all. Nurture peace of mind within us, as well as peace in our homes and in the world. Slow us down like the tick-tock of a clock, and center our lives. Teach us how to be present to what really matters. Oh, on this beautiful day, we take time to give thanks. We know that today is important. And so help us meet today with reverence, with joy, and with intention. And help us be available to today to be used to the fullest. Amen and amen.
The rainy skies of the Pacific Northwest often create conditions where it's easy to find rainbows. Whatever condition you find the same sky in above your head now, I send you forth with blessing. Sending you forth to be the people God made you to be. Rainbow chasers, justice makers, beloved, so that you might know how to share divine love with those who need it most. Blessings. Peace be with you. Happy Pride, y'all.
Happy Pride, Epworth. As we go forth from this place, let us remember that as long as any of us are chained, none of us are free. Our liberation is indelibly connected to the liberation of those more marginalized than we are. As we go forth, let us do so in the name and in the way of Jesus, sharing that good news of God's love and the liberation that God desires for all of us. Amen.